So today we are discussing on the high performance liquid chromatography. Instrument, what are the instruments are required from the HPLC? The first one is pump, mixing in our unit, injector, and guard column, analytical column, detector, and recording integrator. So pump is solvent delivery system. So mixing unit and gradient control the solvent degassing. So injector manually auto injector. So pump solvent delivery system. Solvent mobile phase must be passed via the column at the rate of high pressure 1000 to 3000 psi. Minimum is 500 psi, maximum is 5000 psi. So because of the particular size stationary phase, a few microns is 5 to 10 microns. So different types of pumps are available. Mechanical pumps operate the constant flow rates and use the spare push piston. This type pump is used in analytical scale. Like pneumatic pumps operate the with constant pressure and use the highly compressed gas. So the solvent used must be high purity, preferably HPLC grade, filtered through the 0.45 microns filters. So check values to control the flow rate of solvent and back pressure. So pulse dampener, so to dampen, make the slightly wet the pulses. Then this HPLC is also how the mixing, gradient controller and solvent degassing. So these are the two types of mixing units: low pressure mixing chamber, which is for gassing, degassing the solvents. High pressure mixing chamber does not require for degassing solvents. So mixing solvents is done either by the sticking mixer or dynamic mixer. Sticking mixer packed with the beds. Dynamic mixer uses a magnetic stirrer or operate that under high pressure. Gradient controller. So this gradient controller in an isochromatic separation mobile phase is samely polarity throughout the process. In gradient elution technology, the polarity of the solvent is gradually increased and hence the solvent composition has to be changed. Hence a gradient control is used when two or more solvent pumps are used for such separations. Solvent degassing. Several gases are soluble in organic solvents. So when solvents are pumped under the high pressure, gas bubbles are formed, interfere the separation process of three methods: the vacuum filtration and purging and ultrasonification, and also vacuum filtration, which can be remove the air bubbles but is not also always reliable and complete. By purging throughout the solvent, very effective, is expensive. Ultrasonifications. By using ultrasonicator, which converts the ultra high frequency to mechanical vibration, this causes removal of air bubbles. Injector, manual or auto injector. Spectrum injector, stop flow online and rehydrated injection. So loop valve type. So first of all, spectrum injectors. Injecting the through the rubber spectrum not common, has to withstand high pressure. Stop flow online, in which flow of mobile phase is stopped for a while, and the sample is injected through the value device. So redite injector, the valve loop valve type, and the popular injector. This has a fixed volume loop like 20 microliters or 50 microliters. Our injector has two modules. So those are load position, injector mode. So load position is when sample is loaded in the loop, and injector mode is when the sample is injected. Guard column. It has a very small quantity of absorbent, improves the life of the analytical column. Also act as a pre-filter to remove particular matter, if any, and also other materials. Like guard column has a same material as that analytical column, good has a gut column does not contribute any separations. Analytical column, the most important part of the HPLC technology, is which decide the efficiency of separation. The column materials, stainless steels, mostly used glass polyethylene and also polyethylene ether ketone latestly. So column length is 5 cm to 30 cm. Column diameter is 2 mm to 50 mm. But this particle size is 1 microliter to 20 microliters, and particle nature is spherical, also uniform, and porous materials are used. Surface area, 1 gram stationary phase wave provides the surface area ranging from the 100 to 800 square meters. Her average is 400 square meter. So what are the functional groups? The functional groups in stationary phase depends on the type of chromatic, like chromatographic separations. In normal phase, the contents of saline groups and hydroxy groups. In reverse phase, the C18, C8, C8, C4, these are the octyl desilane and octyl column and butanol column and nitrile column and amino column. So detector, coming to the detectors, UV detector used based upon the light absorption characteristics of the sample. The type of these detectors are available: fixed wavelength detector and variable wavelength detector. Fixed wavelength detector, which operates the 250 nanometers where most drug compounds absorb. Variable detector, variable wavelength detector, which can be operated from the 190 nanometers to 600 nanometers. Refractive index detector, non-specific or universally detector, not much used, low sensitivity and specificity. Fluorometric detector, more specificity and sensitivity. Dimeritic, like say some compounds are not fluorescent. So conductive detector and amphimetric detector and also photo detector are array detectors. Recording on intergradients. So recorders are used to record the response obtained from the detector after the amplification. They record the baseline and all the peaks obtained with the respect to the time. But the area of individual peaks cannot be known. So intergrader improved versions of recorders with data processing capabilities. So these are the height and width peaks when peak area and area integrator provides with the more information on the peak than the recorders. So what are the applications? Finally, what are the applications? The qualitative analysis and checking the purity of compounds and presence of impurities, and quantitative analysis and multi-component analysis and determinations of mixtures of drugs, isolations and identifications of drug, isolations and identifications of mixture components, and biopharmaceutical and pharmacokinetic studies and stability studies and purifications of compounds and environmental applications, forensic applications, biochemical separation and biotechnology, and also food analysis, what else, what not. So everything is available. So HPLC means a lot of things we will know about the diagnosis of diagnostic particle, like biological, pharmaceutical, everything we will know about that. We are estimating this method by using this method. Thank you very much.